We want to look today at Matthew 6 and begin to look at our Lord's teaching on how his disciples should pray. If you read in Luke 11, they actually came to him and said, "Lord Jesus, would you teach us to pray like John taught his disciples to pray?" I always like to ask men that are trying to shape others, disciple others, have you taught anyone how to pray lately? And it can get quiet, because I think we always think of a body of truth, a body of knowledge, but how about how to pray? Christ says, "Let me give you a pattern of how I want you to pray." And he begins, "Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name." I have to say that for years, that never meant anything to me, because it was just a rote prayer. In many churches, we'd stand, "Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name." Go through it in less than 2 minutes, sit down and say, "We just prayed," and not really know a thing about it. I finally begin to understand, Jesus tells us these are the issues, the matters of concern that I want you to be concerned with when you pray. The first one I want you to be concerned with is your Heavenly Father and your relationship to him. Listen to what he says. "Our Father," he didn't say "my Father," he's including the disciples. "Our Father, we have a God who's become our Father through Jesus Christ." Are you aware of that? You can call him all the big names in the Bible, Adonai, Jehovah, Elohim, and go on and on. And those names are true of him. But he wants you to approach him on the basis of relationship. Are you his child? Have you come to know him through Jesus Christ? Now come and say, "Father, I've come." And notice what he says. And when you pray, say, "Our Father who art in heaven," not my earthly Father, but my Heavenly Father, "hallowed be thy name." Now let me ask you a question. Is the name of God holy? The word hallowed means holy. Is God holy? All the way through the Bible, hundreds of times, God says he's holy. Over and over. Is he asking us to pray, "God, you're holy"? No, no, no. He is that. He says, "Let me treat you as holy. Hallow it, set apart, holy be your name." And name stands for all that God is. It stands for his character, his activity. It represents all that God is. Help me today to treat you as who you are, with reverence, with respect, with holy awe. I'm asking you, the first concern of my life today is how I treat you. In my thinking, in my activity, how I spend money, how I use my eyes, what I say with my words. Will you be hallowed? Will you be treated as holy? Will you be treated as reverenced and to be feared, to be loved, to be adored? Is that the first prayer on my heart? Or gimme, gimme, gimme. Gimme this, gimme that. Or we start telling God what to do. Do this, do that, as though he needs instructions. He doesn't need your instructions. He needs your reverence. He needs your adoration. He needs you to get before him, say, "Use my body, my life, to treat you as holy, to treat you as you deserve." Are you hallowing God in prayer? The first place we use sometimes the acronym ACTS: adore God, confess your sin, give him thanks, and then supplicate or make your request known. Well, the first place to begin is, let me treat you with a reverential, adoring heart. Then I'll walk today in a holy awe of you. That's where we've got to start. We've got to get transcendent. We've got to get above it all the clatter of this world. Treat this God that is holy and set apart. Treat him holy in your life. What a prayer for us. What a goal every day of our lives. resume with us this next time that you can, and we'll continue to see how Jesus teaches us to pray.